is in the advertisement is the message. The message is that idea, information, literature, and theme you wanted to communicate to your targeted customers. The message will be decided according to the targeted customer, because you will definitely only transfer important information to your targeted audience, but a trace. The important thing to note here is that the message will be changed when you will change the source of advertisement. It means that selection of media will define the message, because you cannot run a big picture on radio. And someone want enter. Third is media. Media is the most important component in the advertisement. There are so many media available for advertisement, but selection is at the same time so much more critical. The decision of media selection depend on the target market, because the organization will first analyze how its target market gets information about organization, where they are connected to the internet or through the traditional media. And the last point is measurement. Same like marketing strategy, evaluation and measurement is an essential step to ending advertisement strategy. Without evaluation, how you can identify that you achieve your objectives? Same in the case of advertisement, you have to measure your advertising strategy that either you get the same return or not. Next slide. Classification of advertising. There are four categories where advertisement is classified. First is by target audience. Second is by geographical area. Third is by medium. Fourth is by purpose. By targeted audience, it further divided into consumer, business, and by geographical area, it is divided in four categories, both segments, especially local, regional, national, and international. It's depend overall on the product, what kind of product you are selling or service you are providing. Then fourth is by medium. It is further divided in print, broadcast, out of home, direct to mail. Again, it is depend on the your type of customer, what type of customer you are targeting. Then by purpose, it is further divided into product, non-product, commercial, non-commercial, action, awareness. Next slide. What are the objectives of, excuse me, I'm drinking water. What are the objectives? So, primary demand. Advertising is intent to stimulate use of category of products. Then second is selective demand advertising, is intent to encourage purchase of a particular brand or the product and services of a specific firm. Third is comparative advertising. Comparative advertising involves comparing a product to its competing brand. It may be direct naming competition through outright, less direct to the competitor, but not naming them. Like earlier, we have seen many advertisement of Patanjali where he is competing with Dabur, and they are directly not naming them. They compare only the products. And fourth is public service advertisement. Here is public service advertisement is directed at the social welfare of the community or nation. Here I pasted one pick, fourth pick, where took where a car and heavy vehicle is collide. It shows the one should limit his speed while driving on the highways. So it is a directly correlated to the public service, because it is related to the safety of the humans. Next slide. Advertising management. Now we have come to the point, advertising management. Advertising simply put is telling and selling the product. Advertising management is a complex process of employing the various media to sell a product or a service. This process is begins quite early from the marketing research and encompasses the media campaigns that help to sell the product. Without an effective advertising management process in place, the media campaigns are not that fruitful and the whole marketing process goes for a toss. Hence, companies that believe in an effective advertising management process are always a step ahead in the terms of selling their goods and service. Next slide. The advertising management process. Advertising management process involves following things. First, advertising strategy. In it, setting objective, formatting budget, creating ad messages, selecting ad media and vehicles, strategy implement, assessing ad effectiveness, knowing the objective. One should first know the objective or the purpose of advertising. What message is to be delivered to the audience? Then finding out the market behavior, knowing the competitors, what type of advertising they are using, what is the response of the consumer, availability of the resource needed in the process. Targeting audience. Then in this step, targeted consumer most likely to be buy the product. The target should be the appropriately defined without any confusion. For example, if the product is a health drink for a growing kids, then the target customer will be the parents who are going to buy it and not the kids who are going to drink it. Then the point is selection, ad media and vehicles. So media selection is a very important point because now that the target audience is identified, one should select an appropriate media for advertising so that the customers who are to be informed about the product and are willing to buy are successfully reached. Then setting the budget. Then advertising budget has to be planned so that there is no shortage fund or excess of fund during the process of advertising. And also there are no losses to the company. Then we come into the point, creating ad and message. Designing, creating the ad. That is the outline of ad on papers is made the copyrights of the agency. Then the actual creation of ad is done with the help of art directors, not the creative personnel of the agencies. Then perfect ad implementation. Then assessing ad effectiveness. Then the created ad is re-examined and the ad is redefined to make it perfect to the enter the market. Next slide. Next slide, please. Hello. Hello. Okay. It is loading. Actually, there is a network problem. Okay. Advertising.
What issue?
Hello.
Yes, is it visible?
Yeah, ma'am. Ma'am, it was loading. Ma'am. That's why I can't see it correctly.
Okay.
It's correctly. Advertising objectives. There are mainly five words that summarize the objective of advertising. First is who, specify the targeted market. We have discussed it earlier. Then what is the role of your advertising campaign in your overall marketing efforts? Then where, which geography markets need to be emphasized? Then when in it, schedule to implement various parts of the campaign and expected time of the responses. And last point is how often. How often should be the brand be advertised? Next slide. Hello. Okay. Budgeting consideration and practices. I also discussed it in earlier, but I use this PPT here. What ad objective, how much are competitors spending, how much money is available. these are the point which finance department is kept in their mind while making a advertisement for the company, and they know the competitors spending, because if a company is low budgeted company, he can't use lot of money up their company to make a attractive advertisement. So okay ma'am, next slide. I have discussed it in earlier slide. Creating the advertising message strategy, creative concept, message execution, message strategy, general message. It is all related to the how to you create the advertising message. It should be simple, general message, should understandable, and it should be creative, and should use proper media, and convert what you idea you have into the right action. Like nowadays we are seeing a advertisement of phone pay, where Amir Khan and Alia Bhatt is playing a role, police officer in a lady, in which they wanted to send the message that everyone has phone pay in their phone. But only the person who don't have phone pay is a person in a police officer who are at the higher position. So we can consider is it a creative concept. So next slide. Media selection. Which media effectively get the message to the desired audience? What scheduling of this media will neither bore people with too frequent repetition of the message nor let too many people forget the message. It is all related to the how you are sending your advertisement to the right audience and not teasing them. If advertisement is frequently come before you, will be tired. So the right selection of the media is very important in this place. Next slide. This slide involves what type of media is available for advertising. In the era of internet, there is lot of channel is available, but in traditional media, television, radio, outdoor, direct mail, print, and telemarketing was the popular in earlier time. Next slide. In digital media, nowadays is very famous. Digital marketing is everyone is using for promoting their product and their company. So in this email, sending email, digital display like billboards, affiliate marketing, search engine marketing, social media and social networking, internet, radio and broadcast. These are very interesting medium of sending the message of the product. Then next point is guerrilla and earned media. Events, sponsors, PR. We are seeing many PR companies nowadays who is promoting a specific person or product or services. So next slide. Hello. Evaluating advertising effectiveness and return on the advertising investment. This slide is all about the how your advertisement performance. This is the last step to judge the performance of the ad in terms of the responses from the customers, whether they are satisfied with the ad and the product. Did the ad reach to the all the targeted people? Was the advertise capable enough to compete with other players? It's every point is studied properly and changes are made. Next slide. हेलो हेलो मैम प्रतिभा मैम,
Yes, due to network issue, it is going.
या मैम, सो दिस इज द स्लाइड इज ऑल द एचटीपी मार्केटिंग मॉडल. देर आर मेनी मार्केटिंग मॉडल बट दिस इज द वन ऑफ देम, एचटीपी मार्केटिंग मॉडल. इन दिस मार्केटिंग मॉडल वी डिवाइड द मार्केट in first in segmentation. The first step of the STP process is to segment your market. In this step, you divide your market into groups based on the some criteria. There are number of criteria you can use to segment your market. It can be divided according to demography, geography, place, according to the customer, age, gender, sex, and there are many tech segment. Is it are all depend your product, what type of product or service you are offering to the customer. Then targeting involves deciding which of the segment you have identified are the most attractive. Essentially, you are trying to determine the commercial attractiveness of each segment. Then positioning. In the final step, positioning, you map out the different variables considered in the previous two steps and positions your product differently to work your competitors in the mind of your customers. You wanted your product or service to take a unique position in the market. In marketing terms, this is called your value propositions. Next slide. So this is promotional message. This is the marketing tool. After advertising your product, how you sell your product in an effective way. The promotional mix refers to the blend of several promotional tools used by the business to create, maintain, and increase the demand for good and service. It involves advertising, selling, direct marketing, sales promotion, public relations. Next slide. Hello. Personal selling promotional mix. It is the part of promotional mix which involves a one-to-one communication between buyers and customers. Just a minute. As it is one-to-one communication, it generates direct contact with it generates direct contact with the prospects and customers. Even though it is considered to be one of the most expensive form of promotion, it is also considered to the most successful as a seller buyer relationship can be created and developed in it. Next slide. Next slide. Hello. Advertising. One of the key factor in the promotional mix which contribute to a brand building and also how the market perceives the company is advertising. It is always a big part of that promotional mix because of the far and wide reach of advertising and the message that you can send your existing and potential customers. Good advertising can be build a sold brand for the company, and one other hand, bad advertising with a wrong message can causes the brand or a product to fail. Next slide. Direct marketing. While advertising targets a mass audience, the marketing targets prospect and customer. Social media marketing, email marketing, internet marketing are all types of direct marketing used by companies. They have become important in the promotional mix lately because people are using internet for more than they used two decades back. Companies employ direct marketing in order to engage in one-way communication with its customer about the product announcement, special promotion, order confirmations, as well as customer inquiries. Next slide. sales and marketing promotions. Sales promotion are one of the most common types of the promotion used by the companies. Example, using coupons, product sample, and all about this. Nowadays or earlier, we see how companies are selling their products and promoting their products by providing sales, discounts, coupons. So next slide. Public relation. No, next slide. Public relation. Lastly, public relations enables an organization to influence a targeted audience. Through this, create a favorite and positive image for the company. The company tries to connect with the audience by sharing information with them about the company and about the product. If anything goes wrong on the information front, the public relations department has stepped forward and rebuilt the public image of the company and product. Next. Ma'am, I think we have left. Okay, fine. PR agencies in India. These are the top PR agencies. We work as a public relations agencies for a company, for a person. So next slide. And this slide is like concluding slide. What advertisement and what advertisement management can do. It can do remind the target audience to buy the product, announce a new product, brand or services, and made a brand, create brand awareness. Because there is, if you are offering of same product and who are your competitor, then if you're using advertising management, you can create a brand awareness among the people. Then stimulate impulse buying, increase confidence in a brand or a company, fight competitions, change attitude of the people. Next slide. This is the final slide and conclusion. Key to good advertising, the most important step lies in the deciding what advertising should say and to whom it should say. And all there is a need to do is to decide who buys and uses your products and why. In order to spend media dollars wisely, the advertiser must know what they read or watch so that they will see your ads. Next slide. Hello. So thank you. This was all about the advertising management. And if you have any queries, you can ask. Hello.
Yes, thank you, Virendra. Anyone have any questions regarding this? I think no one have any questions. Okay, thank you, Virendra.
Okay, no problem. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, dear.
I think someone is saying something.
Hello. What happened?
Someone is saying something, but his or her voice is not clear. I mean, he can write the message.
Yes. Write in chat box if anyone have any query regarding this.
Well, it is very interesting subject. Well, everyone is advertising on their own way. And we also watch many advertisements everywhere. Hello?
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Fine, ma'am. I think no one has any query.
Okay, thank you. So, who's next? I think Vivek Rajan.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now share your screen and start.
Hello.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. So, hi, good morning. My name is Vivek and I'm going to present my presentation on how to do a financial analysis of any company. So basically, this is a very hands-on presentation where you can learn how to do a financial analysis or like financial statement analysis. So basically, first we have to learn how many type of financial statement we have. So there is basically five type of financial statement. One is a income statement. Second one is balance sheet. Third one is a change in equity statement, and fourth is cash flow, and fifth is note to financial statement. So basically, there is two most important financial statement that every finance manager has to think about. First is income statement, that is called P&L statement, and second one is balance sheet. So basically, in this presentation, I gonna focus on income statement and balance statement. So yeah. So as we know, for the survival of any business, the business must be a profitable and must be a solvency. So for the profitability, we can look upon the income statement, how much we earn, how much we expense, and how much our net income is. And the solvency is all about how much we own and how much we owe, like our asset and liabilities that we gonna see in our balance sheet. So here we go to our balance sheet. So here I can present one of the balance sheet of one company that is called Polypanel. So here we see the P&L statement. So basically in P&L statement, you can see here is the items of P&L statement. Basically this P&L statement is consists of 2014 to 2007. And we can how we forecast upcoming, we can see it in this slide, like 2018 to 2010. So firstly, in the first section of the P&L, we can see that the sale. So sale is basically like what the sale revenue was, what the total sale is. So after the total sale, we can minus it. We can see that in the sales is like 977. And in the sale, we can minus the cost of goods sale. It's the cost of goods sale is basically all the expense that we incur to sell a product, like we manufacture a product, we get the manufacturing cost, and when we sell it, after the margin, that is called really the gross margin after all the transportation and all the raw material and the production cost. So then we got the marginal cost, marginal gross margin. In the gross margin, we can minus our operating expenses that we can incur, like our rent, our salary, and other expenses. And from that, we can get the EBITDA, just that we call. So in this company, the EBITDA is in the first year is in minus. That's not the issue because it's the starting company. So we can say why is it in the minus section. So basically, EBITDA is after the minus in all the operating expenses from your balance sheet. Am I audible? Okay.
Yes, you are audible.
So after EBITDA, we can minus our depreciation. Depreciation is basically we can incur the or the particular amount in any fixed asset that we assume to be like they last for as much period. Like if you buy an AC for 1 lakh rupees and we expect that this AC is gonna work for 10 years, then we can divide 1 lakh with 10 and we enter 10,000 each year as a depreciation. So after the minus of depreciation, we got EBITDA. EBIT. So in EBIT is basically those who think big actually matters a lot for a company. Like if EBITDA is good, it's called a company is profitable. So in EBITDA is basically the after EBITDA we can minus the financial result. Financial result is basically if you've taken any loan, so we could minus the interest. We could get the interest, so we can minus that interest cost, and then after we minus the taxes. So then after we got the all the like net income that here the company shows the net income. So here is I can give you some ratios, like the ratio is taken from this onward, like there is a growth to sale ratio. You can see that how can it be calculated is by growth divided by the sale. Like here we can see that the company is growing like 54% to 47% at 2030. The company is growing, we can say that. And there's some more ratio like cost of goods sold by sale. So that is all the ratios that basically show the percentage of the company is growing. But the net income is still, we can see it in the minus for the first two years. And after that, the third year, you can see that the net income is 21. That this is all in crores, so you can say that 21 crores. And there are all other ratios like EBITDA to sale ratio, ROS ratio. So there is all ratio that can be basically, we can assume the rough figure is how the company is performing. Okay, so that's the P&L statement that I saw. I want to go for the balance statement, how we can do and what the all element we are in the balance sheet. So in this company, there is also the same as we can take the 2014 to 2007, the data, the historical data, and we can forecast the upcoming data like 2008 to 2010. So basically in the balance sheet, we have to enter all the asset and all the liabilities. So basically in the asset of any company, we can enter the cash. Here you can see the cash and all the receivable is all the sales you have done by the credit, so that you're gonna receive in future. So that is asset for you, so you can write as an asset. There's other assets, you can say that like inventory is also the other asset, or any you can pay any shares or anything, that is also your asset. Is and here's all the current asset, and here is the company's all the non-current asset. Non-current asset is basically the all the asset those who have less than 1 year, the company whose lifetime is less than 1 year is go to the non-current asset. And here's the liability, all the payable that I have to pay to the our supplier or anything that is entered in the liability sector. There you can see that in 56, you can see that all the payable to the supplier and all the credit lines. Like if you're taking any loans, so there's any interest incurred, that there's also liability for you. All the long term debt is basically your capital or the long-term loan, the capital you have that invested in your company, all your reserve, like after your net income, after distribution, all your profits to your shareholder, then you get those money who have been stored with you are all reserves, and those reserves are reinvested in the company for their future. That's called reserve, and that's all come under the like long-term debt. Okay, so here's one more term in this. You can say that the need for fund. So need for fund is basically calculated. You can say that all the asset, all the current asset minus all the current liabilities. So the money that you need is called the. If there is in positive, you can need money. If there is negative, you have the excess of money. So in this company, they need money because their long-term asset is not sufficient to pay their. It's a short-term. It's non-current asset is not liable to pay their non-current liabilities. So there's, you can see that all is in pile. You also seen formula that I have used. So basically, I gonna show you how is it look. Okay. So basically, we can calculate it by all minus all your current asset, that gives you the points, and we can minus all the current liabilities. So we can get the need for fund. So basically, the need for fund is company is actually increasing, and that gonna continue in the future also. We can see that here, that the company need, like, they have minus of 469 means they have the shortage of fund. So for that, they gonna waive some shares, or they get go for the loans, whatever they suit for. So basically, this is all about the how we do the financial analysis of a statement, financial statement analysis, you can say, and all the items in the financial analysis. So yeah, that's all. Anyone have any questions?
Thank you, Vivek.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Good presentation. So I think Pratyut is also not here.
Yes. Okay.
Okay, thank you so much, both Virendra and Vivek. Both presentation is too good.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much. Now you all can leave.
Okay.